Man, you do that pretty good with that right wrist.
Oh, no.
What's up, Pablo? Oh, okay.
Occasionally, if you let one out, you just got to be courteous to those around you.
Miguel, thank you. They got a couple more seconds, right?
Hey, look. Hey. So this is actually a pretty good one.
No, go ahead. Go ahead.
This is why would you tell them to go ahead?
Copy that.
So look. Some good stuff right here. Some good stuff right here.
Do you remember? Good morning, folks. It is Thursday, March 5th.
I'll tell you what I do remember.
Thursday, March 5th, 2020. And it's coffee time with a smile.
I'll tell you what I do remember.
Smile.
I'll tell you what I do remember.
What do you remember?
I do remember that time I went to one of my friends.
Oh, God, another long story. Look, we've never met before, this is Anthony B. And he's like the song that never ends.
Listen,
he tells the stories that never end.
No, I went to a friend's house, and I had to go to the bathroom. And it was like, oh, shoot. It wasn't a regular bathroom. Okay. It was like, I had to go number two.
Okay, all right.
Hold on, but you realize...
It's the intro.
No one wants to go to someone's bathroom and go number two. Because if you stink it up, number one, you never know if they have freshener. You don't know if they don't have freshener, number one. Number two, they got to make sure there's toilet paper in there. Because if there ain't toilet paper in there, I mean, guys, you're really out back. And number three...
Hold that thought. So if we've never met before, this is Anthony V. And I'm SubaruSteve.
What if you stink it up?
We are here to inform, inspire, motivate, and hopefully bring a smile to your face.
I'm just saying.
To your face. That's right. To your face.
It's kind of like if me and you were talking right now and I just let one loose. That would be totally disrespectful.
You know, I got to tell you this. My sister has a house and where she lives at.
Are you not listening to me?
Where she lives at.
That would be disrespectful, though.
I hear you. But she's got like the living room right here, the dining room right there, and there's a door on that wall. That is right into the bathroom.
What's that got to do with anything?
Well, if you go in there and use that bathroom, anything that smells in that bathroom comes right under the door into the dining room and living room.
Let me ask you a question.
It's right there. If you're sitting in there and you're doing like,
hold on.
Everybody in the room can hear it.
Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
How many times have you blown that bathroom up?
Jesse Switsky, don't go anywhere.
How many times have
you blown that? Don't start touching me, man.
How many times have you blown that bathroom
up? Jesse Switsky, we're going to
tell you. How many times have you blown that bathroom up?
Once or twice, man. I don't go up there.
And did everybody know?
They knew.
Oh, yeah. I know they knew. Because you was terrible, man. Like, you got to get your organs together and stuff,
bro. Yeah, and my man had to go get that cinnamon spray because of him.
Look, this cinnamon spray is not because of me.
Look, tag a friend, folks. We had technical difficulties yesterday. It was called non-compliance from my man Anthony B. here. I'm off on Wednesdays. And we have no mics today because he does such a great job setting stuff up.
They're wireless.
No, there is no live hack sitting here. Good morning, Tim Romo.
They're in the ceiling, bro.
My man is in the ceiling right now.
Oh,
what a feeling. When you're on the ceiling. Anyways, tag a friend, folks. We're giving away a gift card tomorrow. I think you're giving away a gift card tomorrow. For every person you tag, up to five, different people, Lori Johnson.
Can I share something with you?
Why don't you share something?
Are you going to allow me to share it?
Go for it.
So after last Monday when my credit card, my debit card got compromised, I realized, because, I see my alerts, I realized... that someone in Maryland went to a Wells Fargo ATM and took out some cash. My card's in my pocket. How'd they do that?
How'd they do that?
So, of course, and then they did it twice, right? Whatever. Long story short, I cut up the card. I canceled it. They sent me a new card. I just got it back. I got my new card, bro. I got my new card. I'm so excited.
Good.
I can finally use it again.
So what do you do on
that
your
means
day
I can
off
buy.
Week?
That means I can buy lunch.
Look, here's another person.
I can buy lunch.
Okay, well, they want to hear. We
I
got people
lunch.
Popping in right now. Would you calm down?
I can buy breakfast,
calm
too.
Calm the front I door
buy,
down.
What you want? Chick-fil-A, Hardee's?
Yes.
You're not excited? Forget
Hardee's.
You.
Hardee's
no,
on my biscuit.
It's all right. Nope.
All right, anyways.
Nope.
Make sure you tag
Lori,
your friend on this
Lori,
video
what
here.
What you like?
Look, Steve Vela's there too, man.
Because you keep cutting me off when I'm trying to.
Because you're not paying attention to the friggin' show.
I'm trying to be nice.
Just shut up for a minute.
I got my car back.
Just shut
and you
up
don't even
for a minute.
Care.
Shut your
what
mouth.
What if they compromise?
My God, my wife is better than you.
What if they compromise all my money? and you wouldn't care? You just would have told me to shut up?
Yeah, shut up.
I can't be excited that now I can buy breakfast.
Listen, for question
everybody?
Of the day, folks.
You know what I mean? What if I want to buy breakfast for you?
Question of the day.
You know what I'm gonna do? I'm going to go and get breakfast.
Oh, my God, would you stop?
I'm going to get breakfast, and I'm going to get it for myself.
You always do.
And I'm going to eat it in front of you, and you're going to be like, can I have some?
You always
like,
do.
Can I have some? And I'm going to be like, no. No, no. You want to know why I'm going to say no? Because you're being so mean.
Are you done?
You used to be a nice person, but now you're being a mean person. What happened over the day? One day you become a whole different person. Why are you being like this? Why? And you don't even care. You have no look. He has no emotions. You don't even care. That's the problem. Why don't you care?
I'm trying to ask them a question, not you. Are you done?
No.
Jeez, Carla.
I said no.
I love you, baby. This guy, man, I realize how lucky I am to have the wife I have right now. Because you could be like this. Oh, my God.
Sweet.
I deal with this all day. Thank God it's your day off and you're not going to be
here
all day.
I'm your friend. That's your wife.
So what do you do on your day off when you're alone? I enjoy the peace and quiet. But that's the question of the day. What do you do on your day off when you're alone? Nicole. There's Nicole Knoll. Hey, listen. Birthdays today. Jesse Switsky, you know what time it is. If you're still there after his little whiny episode. Who else's birthday is it?
Daniel.
Daniel who?
Shevlin.
Very good. Daniel Shevlin. Mary Freeman Kitts. It's your birthday. Faye Giles, it's not your birthday. No, Faye. Not you. Not you, Nicole. But Mary Freeman Kitts, it's your birthday. Who else?
Is that Dwayne?
That looks like Dwayne. Who?
Johnson.
Dwayne Johnson! Isn't The Rock known as Dwayne Johnson?
If you smell what Dwayne Johnson
Alex
is
Rivera.
Cooking.
Howard, happy birthday, my friend. Who else? Leave your work wife alone. Oh, Nicole, if you only knew.
Steve. Vela.
Steve Vela. Steve Vela, happy birthday. And Mike Grant, come on, man. You know what time it is. Come on. Happy birthday to you all. Happy birthday.
No.
Happy
Why whenever birthday. I want to talk and get things off my chest, you cut me off, man. That was like...
You always want to talk.
If I don't get off my chest,
you always have stuff on your chest.
They say if you keep stuff in long enough, you become crazy. I'm trying to not become like you. I don't want to become like
you. If you touch me again...
This is the problem.
I'm going to grab you and shoot you.
No, there's only one Anthony V. There's 26.
We don't talk about the other one.
You heard that? There's 26 plus one.
Hey, today's National...
Listen! Sit down, Steve. Sit down.
Stop touching me.
Sit down. There's 26 plus... Sit down. Sit down.
Roof.
There's 26 plus one different personalities in you. You want to know why? Because you keep it in. You suppress that stuff. You need to let it out. That's the problem.
No, Dark Hands.
Stop.
Dark Hands, Light Hands.
No one cares about Light Hands, Dark Hands.
Sure they do, Dark Hands.
No, they don't.
Hey, listen, National Cheese Doodle.
You're still cutting me off.
If you're a cheese doodle, you know who you are. That's right. National Absentee Day. National Hospitalist. How do you say that? National Hospitalist Day. And I cannot believe this is a real day, but it really is. We had a very hard time typing this one out.
No, you did.
No, we did.
Mm-hmm.
I don't mean you. I mean us.
Mm-hmm.
True story. You won't believe what today is. We had a hard time believing this, but we got it together. We got it together. What do you mean putting me in my place?
That's what I'm talking about. See, that's the thing. They all know how you are. You, people try to talk and you just cut them off. Like,
we'll
dang.
Hey, hold that thought.
No, I'm talking.
National Mobile.
I'm talking right now. I am
You're
talking
always
right now.
Talking.
I am talking right now. It is National Multiple Personalities Day. Get your little personality out of here. Little body? You a little body, bro. I be in the gym, bro. You see that? You wanna go to the gym with me? You wanna go to the gym with me? No, Steve, get out of here. Go. Hey, yo, bro, you wanna go to the gym with me? We can do push-ups. You can do like 2, I do like 50. See, now that's not the way you wanna live. Put this seat down. You do not wanna live like that. Sit down. Relax.
Oh, I love you, buddy.
No.
Yeah, I still love you. I love you.
See this
like
fist?
I love you like a hemorrhoid.
What? A hemorroid?
I don't love them.
Why would you?
National Multiple Personality Day.
How you gonna say that? I already said that. National Multiple Personality Day.
To who?
You have issues.
Okay. I like that.
You're special.
And you got something Subaru?
I do got something Subaru. Let's go. Let's do it. Come on. Let's go. Move. Get up. Oh. Come on. Here we go. Grab the camera.
Get up. Get down. Get up. Get down. Get down. Get up. Get up. Get down. Get up. Get down. Get down. Get up. Here we go.
Let's go. Come on. Something Subaru brought to you today from Subaru Steve and Anthony V. Guess what? If you ever have a question, you ever want to ask yourself, what is my tire pressure? How do I know how much to put in each tire? PSI. Let me show you. Every vehicle has this located right here. Can you come? Zoom in, zoom in, zoom in, zoom in. Oh man, look at you, Steve. You're a terrible zoomer immer. Right here. It will actually tell you front tire and rear tire how much PSI that you need to put in. How much pressure do you need in that tire? And the great thing about the pressure in the tire, it actually keeps the great gas efficiency and everything that you need. So, something Subaru, brought to you by Subaru Steve and Anthony V. Subaru Steve got issues, man. All these different personalities, I don't know what he's doing in his life. His life doesn't even know what he's doing. You know, I don't know. He got issues, but it's all good. Like, I thought he was a better cameraman. His cameraman ways, you must not have a personality that's camera efficient. You know what I'm saying? Because you got all these other personalities, but the camera efficient personality, I don't know where that personality is at. Yo, I mean, you got 1, 2. I mean, 9's pretty cool. 12 is a crybaby.
Morning, Michael Mills.
You know, 12 is a crybaby. Number 12?
Good morning.
Number 12 is a crybaby.
How are you all today?
Number 12 is a crybaby. What are you doing?
I'm waiting for you. It's your show.
No, number 12 is a crybaby.
Okay. Number 12 is a crybaby.
You would stop crying all the time.
Okay.
Good job. But whoever was actually trying to do this camera, it's terrible, bro. You know, like, whatever personality that was, because it's National Personality Day, I'm only expressing this because now you're finally allowing me to talk, and this is great. Because let's talk about this. Let's really talk about this. You know, in times in life.
It's my message, not yours. Yours is after okay. Mine.
Go ahead.
You call me a goathead? Did you call me a goathead? Listen, I got a message. Coronavirus. All right, I've heard enough of the coronavirus. Okay? You turn the television on, coronavirus. You look at the news, coronavirus. California, state of emergency, coronavirus. Because of a cruise ship, coronavirus. Vacations, coronavirus. Look, folks, I posted something earlier this morning. Did you know that the common flu is 60% more dangerous than the coronavirus? 60 times more dangerous than the coronavirus. And of the coronavirus, if you catch it, your chances are being 2 out of 100 people, 2 of you might die. Come on, stop worrying about it. And they, you know what the precaution is? Wash your hands. Shouldn't we be washing our hands every day anyways? They say cough in your elbow. Well, that's sneezing your elbow. That's to keep other people from getting it. If you don't want to catch it, wash your hands. Use hand sanitizer. Keep your hands clean. Don't rub it into your face. If you get it, it's your own fault. I'm serious. I'm sorry about this, but wash your hands. Only 2% of people who catch the coronavirus actually die. More people die of the common flu every year than the coronavirus. Let's get over it, you know? That's my message. Thank you.
SubaruSteve. Good job, Steve.
Thank you.
That was a good message.
Thank you very
much. You know what I'm saying? I'm proud of you, man.
Thank you.
You did a great job just now.
That's because I'm not going to get the coronavirus.
But you know, but you did a great job, man. You know what? Your kids and your grandson and your wife would be proud of you.
Good morning, Susan.
You want to know why they'd be proud of you?
Why would they be proud
of
me?
Because you're a great guy.
Well, thank you.
You continue to surprise me. You continue to step up to the plate. You continue to outdo yourself over and over and over again. You know what? I'm impressed. You know what? You could be a role model. You're not my role model, but you could be a role model.
Oh, I'm number 12 and I don't like that because, you know, I want to be a role model.
Good job, man.
Let's stop at 12. Okay.
And so did you notice everything I just said?
That I'm not your role model.
These are all positive affirmations. Great words.
Well, if I can't be your role model, that's not positive.
Listen, you're a great individual. I'm proud of you. Good job. Congratulations. Keep doing what you're doing. And you know what? Sometimes people need to hear this. Instead of saying something negative, maybe we should change our words. Maybe we should say more positive things more often to other individuals.
You are awesome.
And the reason I say that, because we hear no so much, especially as young kids. We hear no so much. I know you heard it, Steve. No, no. Because you was... No.
I still hear it.
From you. I don't say no.
No, no, no. Yes, you do.
I don't say no.
Dark hands, light hands. Dark hands, light
hands. That's the problem.
See?
What does that have to do with anything positive?
Flip the script.
We're talking about flip positive.
The script. Flip the
positive
script.
Words, man. I just hit you with like a 12-piece nugget. That's what I'm going to call it. I hit you with a 12-piece nugget. 12 positive words. You know what you... Tonight, I challenge you to say 12 positive words to your wife.
Honey, I'm so glad you're not Anthony V. Honey, you don't talk as much as Anthony V.
That's not, none of this is
honey,
positive.
You cook better than Anthony V. That is positive.
None of this is
I'm
positive.
I'm building her up.
No, yeah. Because what
honey,
you're
I'm
doing.
I'm so glad to be
this
married
is what
to
you're doing.
You
this
instead
is,
of Anthony V.
No, this is what you're doing. You're churning a negative, but then you throw that negative on me.
No.
Yes, I'm right here. I'm right here.
Oh.
I'm right here.
Hey, buddy.
What are you talking about?
How are you?
And she don't cook better than me. What you mean?
You said when I go home and talk to my wife.
I said, I need you to say 12 positive words about your wife to her, man.
Warm, soft, cuddly. Great, sweet.
Don't say that right now. Say that to your wife later.
She'll be watching.
No, she's not going to watch.
She watches us.
Don't watch.
Morning, Aaron Whale. How
don't
are
watch.
You?
Get off. I want
to. You want my wife to get off? What?
Get off the
what?
Camera. Man, oh. Shut up, man. No, because what I want her to say, you know what? Steve listened, and he actually said some positive things. This may take your relationship to a whole nother level. I know y'all been married forever.
All
however.
Of us. Well, most of us.
However. I don't know what that means. But however, guess what?
What?
It could go to another
if you
level.
You hit me again. So help me.
It. So help you who?
That's right, us.
Who's us?
You know, I got a question I want to ask everybody.
Us on the bus.
Us on the bus.
Us on the bus.
Wheels on the bus go round and round.
No,
round
why
and
you
round,
keep changing
round
the
and
song?
Round. Wheels on the bus go round and round all day long. Okay, so question for you people out there. For national multiple person... Oh, I'm not going to read this. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. Okay. For National Multi-Personality Day, number 16 is wondering, should all of your personalities be... Oh, you're kidding me, 16. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. No. Number 16 is wondering, should all of your personalities be individually named or numbered? Is numbering your personalities okay?
Why are you asking this?
Yes, it is. No, it's not. Yes, it is. Okay. Anyways.
Yeah, I'm about to call the police.
And when I have a day off and I'm alone... The problem is, I'm never alone!
Okay. Hey, excuse you.
Shut up. All right.
Hold on. You. Viewer advised. Cocaine is a hell of a drug.
Woo!
SubaruSteve has issues. I have no clue what he's doing on his spare time.
Clues.
Yeah, you gotta find another Paul Prince.
Find another money.
That's the second clue.
What?
We know what the clues say. You know what to do. Use terrible. Okay, bro? You gotta get better. I was trying to stay positive with this. However, you're just all over the place.
You're a pretty good guy, man. You know, when I think about us...
No. There's no us.
There's us. There's me and you and a dog named Boo. And
no, there's no us.
There's sunshine on bananas and rain...
Sunshine on bananas.
And rain on the oranges.
What?
But when you take the pink tire pressure from the...
What are you talking about?
From the leaves that are blue... Blue leaves, like in Avatar, and then
there's no blue leaves in Avatar.
Baseball cap on.
There's no blue leaves
and
in Avatar.
You flip the script of life and you turn the lights on bright.
No lights.
Then Kayla Clark pops in and says, "What
Kayla,
in the world are they doing?" Yes, it's
tripping.
National Multiple Personality Day today,
he's
folks.
Tripping.
And I'm stuck with this one.
He's tripping.
A figment of my imagination.
I'm very real.
I heard it.
I'm very real.
You got
however,
high fives?
No, no, hold on. I have a life hack.
You are a life hack.
For you to say that some of the things...
Hey, blue, nice watch. Nice
you
watch,
talking man. About blue leaves what? And tire pressure.
Pink tire pressure.
And what the world does that have to do with? Like, that's almost like saying, look, let me go and walk the fish while the dog is in the goldfish bowl.
Exactly.
Like, why would you even say that?
Because that's how we feel. Sense. That's how we feel when you take circulation.
That's like the hamster being in the kitty litter and a kitty being inside the tank.
When you take,
what is that got to do with
intrinsic
anything?
Intrinsic circulation. You and have you stand no... in front of a self checkout at Walmart.
What are you talking about?
Somebody said the other day, you walk into Walmart and go, "Do y'all sell Ouija boards?" Everybody stares at you. Well, we don't have that problem. We don't, because when we go in, we just go look for them.
What are you talking about?
Exactly. And the basements in a Walmart are kept secret.
What are you talking about?
That's exactly right. Kayla Clark has a hurting brain.
Your brain hurts?
You should go to an optometrist so he can take a bigger look at your brain.
Hold on, you should get some brain help.
Fun for your brain.
Brain help. There's brainologists.
Brainologists.
Yeah.
Well, you're certainly not one.
I'm not trying to be one. However, I'm a get away from Subaru Steveologist.
You got life hacks for today?
I do have some.
Oh, I do have them. Where you going to?
You know what? I'm going to get breakfast for myself.
You already said that.
Yeah, because you're mean to me, man. You should be a nice person,
shut up,
bro.
12. Okay.
I missed yesterday, so you want to talk about yesterday?
Oh, yeah. He missed yesterday big time. There was no rewind last night.
Stop.
You know who called me at 2 minutes after
8? Can you stop and listen?
This man. My first question was, dude, why aren't you live right now?
You know what?
I said, what? He goes, and then I find out he's in the building. I'm right here now. I said, well, why aren't you live?
You know what?
People were looking for
you.
You, Wednesday. First Wednesday. First Wednesday.
Next time, I'm going to let your customers, I'm going to let someone else get them.
Hold the press, Batman. So we came in Tuesday morning at 7:30 in the morning. Well, 7:45 in the morning.
Stop.
And he calls me up yesterday morning
Steve.
To tell me he's not online live because he was here till 11:30 at night.
I didn't say 11:30.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't say
what time did you say?
I said 10:45.
No, you did not. You said after 11.
I said 10:45.
Okay. I recorded the call.
You know, I don't care if you record the call.
Oh, now he's getting touched away.
Yeah, I'm getting touched because you know
you're
what
getting touched?
No, because you know what your customers asked me?
What?
Anthony, can you please stay? We don't want to deal with anybody else. And so if someone asked me that, because guess what? They said, we know, this is exact words, we know you want to go home. And I was like,
no, I don't.
And then I realized it was Super Steve's customer. So I need to make sure they got the Super Steve and Anthony V touch. So if I allowed someone else to take care of them, how would they ever get the Super Steve and Anthony V touch? So I had to do what I thought was right.
Greg Watson.
For the people.
That's right.
So, you can say all you want to say.
No, no, no. Number 17. Number 17 here. And I got to. No, no, no.
Yesterday.
17
there are two ways to be rich.
Rich Sarkowski, our lot manager?
One is to have all you want. The other is to be satisfied.
Satisfied? What the heck is satisfied?
Can you be quiet?
You said satisfied.
Can you just stop?
What is satisfied?
The people trying to hear the message and you just killing the vibe. There are two ways to be rich. One is to have all you want. The others is to be satisfied with all you have.
Oh, now he says satisfied on purpose. Hey, don't do that.
With your sketch, your glasses.
To be satisfied with all you have. You know, I agree with that. People spend all their time, but you can have anything you want.
You know what, Steve? This is what we're going to do to you.
Oh, that was yesterday's life hack.
We're going to get a permanent
and
marker.
Today's Steve. Life hack brought to you by Anthony
Excuse
V.
Me. Stop.
On top.
Can you stop talking? Get a permanent marker on your body.
What?
If you get a permanent marker on your body.
No, you just said get a permanent marker on your body. Can
get
I put one on your body?
A permanent marker on your body.
It's a question mark. Yeah.
Question.
You said it as a statement.
Be quiet. Go over the marks with a highlighter. And it will rub right off.
No way.
Let's try it. You want to try it?
I'll give you a Sharpie and a highlighter.
I'm going to get a Sharpie.
Me. Yeah. You're going to put it on you?
Go and get it, man.
No, you're going to draw it on you.
Come on.
Are you going to draw
Go.
It on you?
Hurry up.
Are you going to do it?
Go.
No, you're not putting
yes,
it on
Yes, sure.
You.
Come on.
No. Look, I bought shoe polish yesterday. Look,
I don't care.
Look at those shoes,
Steve,
man.
Can you go get it?
Those are nice looking shoes.
Steve, stop.
These are leather Adidas Ultra Boots. Let go of my shoes. Man, you rubbed the polish
off.
Come
on, man. We're supposed to be doing the marker. Go get the marker.
Oh, wait. I'm sorry. I didn't know we were live.
Go get the marker.
Hey, good morning.
Wait a minute. I got to get my shoe on. Let me get my shoe on.
Walk over there without it.
Okay. Hey.
Go get the marker.
Okay.
Come on, man.
Hey, how are you all today? It's nice to see you.
The people are waiting, man. Permanent marker, highlighter. Do you have something where I can...
Right there.
No, I need something to rub it off with.
No, you don't need to. It says it rubs right off.
No, but... Oh, my gosh. Let's try this, y'all.
Okay, here
so
we
look,
go.
Life hacks for today. Get a permanent marker on your body. Go over the mark with a highlighter. It will rub right off. So, we got a highlighter.
We did not plan this.
And we got a Sharpie. You see, it's a Sharpie.
Permanent marker.
Extreme fade resistance.
Permanent marker.
Permanent marker. All right, I'm going to do this right here. I'm going to do a smiley face.
You're counterfeit.
What you talking about?
Why'd you have to go so detailed, man?
So, I got to... Why are you...
I want to make sure it's dried on there.
Stop blowing your hot breath on me. Bro, get out of here.
Well, you liked my hot breath last night.
Bro, I didn't even see you yesterday.
Okay, here we go. Is it going to rub right off with a highlighter? Oh,
shoot.
Wow.
Yo, that's crazy.
Oh, wow. It's like invisible ink.
Yo, it changed your highlighter up. However.
No, it doesn't say anything about that. Look at that.
That's crazy. That's a good one.
Wow. So y'all might be wondering, these life hacks, they work.
What you mean? You give the life hacks a bad time.
You give life hacks
your highlighter
a bad name.
Look at your highlighter, though. Your highlighter's done. Bro.
That's going to be your highlighter, my friend.
What do you mean? Oh, my God.
That will be a highlighter switch off today.
No, I don't have a yellow highlighter.
You certainly won't now. Anyway, that was pretty cool. I like that.
Yeah.
Can you scoot over so we can be like in the middle here?
Bro, don't stop trying to scoot so
That was pretty good, man. That was really interesting. What else is happening? Anything?
Well... I see what else is happening. Daylight saving time, 3 days away.
3 days from you spring forward. You know what I noticed this morning? Is like at 6:30 in the morning, I open the blinds up and the sun's just starting to come up. Well, on Sunday, it's going to be an hour darker in the morning for a little bit.
Well, you know, it was pretty bright last night around like 7.
So that means that Sunday, it's going to be bright till 8 again. We're going to be driving... What we normally thought was dark at 5, 6, and 7, and it's going to be daylight. It's Ozzy Perez. I told you he was watching. He's right there.
What is Kayla talking about? No, stop right there.
Kayla Clark, Olaud, Me Girl 2. What about me? I brought you donuts. Uh-oh, my brain hurts. What about me? Bring us donuts, Kayla. What about you? You're our best girl here, Kayla. You bring us donuts.
We want donuts.
Donuts in the morning, donuts in the day, donuts at night time, donuts in the hay. I love donuts, donuts cool.
No, I am singing a song.
Oh.
We like donuts,
donuts in the morning, donuts.
Stop!
Oh.
It's kind of like the we like candy.
Donuts in the morning, donuts.
No. You're just changing the song. You have to stay on point. Okay.
Oh, she said, what about, you're getting breakfast. What about her? She brought us donuts. She brought you donuts.
Oh, Kayla, you want breakfast?
You want breakfast?
When the show ends, I'm going to call you because he's not getting any.
Oh.
We're going to take a picture of me giving you.
Oh, my breakfast.
Not your breakfast, her breakfast. What are you talking about? We're going to eat breakfast without you. Yeah.
Well, you want to know a secret?
I don't care.
When I got my coffee this morning?
I don't care.
I got a nice hot. Sausage, egg, and cheese.
I bet
biscuit.
You did get a sausage, egg, and cheese.
For myself.
Biscuit. For yourself.
And we all ate it and loved it.
I don't care.
We had a good time.
Congratulations.
You weren't supposed to tell them that.
We're proud of you.
I didn't really get a biscuit. Party's omelet biscuit would be
awesome. It doesn't
awesome.
Matter.
Is that it? Anything else going on? Daylight saving time's 3 days, March 8th. St. Patrick's Day coming up on Tuesday, the 17th. When does spring begin? Spring's
Kayla,
coming.
Was that you that posted that? The guy that was like, shake it off, shake it off. And the little girl was like, bro.
First time I touched you in 3 days.
No, it wasn't.
It was.
You touched me out there.
Touch Touch me in the morning.
You was out there trying to hit me up, and I was like,
then just walk away.
Outside of that,
spring is coming on Thursday, March 19th.
So now you just want to be on point?
2 weeks from today, spring. Spring is coming. And a month from now, on the 18th of April, it's going to be a super...
Subaru Saturday!
And all of y'all are invited.
Did you hear how I did it? That was pretty good.
That was pretty good. Man.
Can you do that?
Like, let's get ready to rumble!
It has to be... Bro,
hey, what is your favorite thing to do on a beach? On a beach.
Stay away from SubaruSteve.
Yeah, we can do that. So, what's your favorite thing to do on a beach, folks?
Well, when I was younger, it used to be boogie boarding.
Boogie boarding.
Now it's to relax, stay under the tent, and drink some beer.
Oh man, see, I'm thinking about getting a cabana on my
cruise. A cabana. I'm getting a cabana.
Cabana. But what's your favorite thing to do on a beach, folks? Because the Subaru Guru cruise is coming up. And we want you to come watch us do this craziness live in the Caribbean on board the boat, poolside, 8 a.m. on Tuesday, April 9th. I got that out, didn't I? Good try. I saw what you were trying to do there. I like that. Anyways, for more information, I want you to call Cruise Ship Skip right now at
757-431-2111.
Or 406-4701.
No.
406-4701.
I saw you forget and you had to look.
No, I was... What? That's Anthony B's phone number, folks. He likes your phone calls. Call him up. He loves talking to you. 757-406-4701.
Why do you keep punching?
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. 12 quick.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that.
Okay. Thank you. All right. Can't beat the beast. Anyways.
I'm scared.
Don't be scared.
They're scared. We're all scared.
Be scared. Don't be scared. Be scared. Don't be scared. Be scared. Don't be scared. Be scared. No. Yes. No. Yes. Okay. Steve. Anyways, I think it's time we end the show. Steve. I'm going to take a walk. I'm going to take a long walk off a short pier. I'll be back
tomorrow. Shock treatment.
Oh, it's time for me to go.
Electric shock treatment. Might work for SubaruSteve, y'all. Because we have no clue what's really going on. However, what is going on, it is the 5th of the month. And you already know what time it is. If it's the 5th of the month, that means you got to finish the day 5-0. Who runs the day? Do you run the day? Or does the day run you? Superman and Batman are here for you, the people. Okay, that was enough. I can't do it no more. I try to have my Superman voice. You know what I mean? You know how in the movies, they'll be like, is that a bird? Is that a plane? It's...
off. Show's over. Good show, man. Good show. Enjoy your day off today, man. I know you got a lot to do and a lot of places to go.
Get some breakfast for me and Kayla.
Well, that's pretty nice of you. I think Kayla would really appreciate that.
You know what I mean? Hey, this cinnamon can, bro, this drink definitely came in handy when you blew it up in here.
Man, you really ruined my highlighter. Look at that.
But it went away.
What do you mean it went away? It's still on.
I mean, like, the life hack.
So how do you get the permanent marker off the highlighter?
No, I mean.
So you got the permanent marker off your skin onto the highlighter.
Well, that's another life hack.
Oh, man, I got to wait? I'm not waiting.
Yeah, bro, that was a good life hack, though.
That's gone.
That was probably the first life hack that we've tried, and it, like, worked, like, right then and there. Because most of the life hacks, we're not in positions.
I remember you trying that one that said, if you're going to puke, put the tongue in the top of your mouth, and you tried that and puked. I didn't get that at all.
No, that never happened.
That's strange.
You're strange.
Today's not the 4th, man. Did you really have the 4th up?
You like that?
You did. You had the 4th up.
You like that?
The 5th.
You like that?
And it's not Wednesday, it's Thursday.
You like that?
You moved it up one day because you didn't do the show yesterday.
You like that?
Oh, you're funny. I feel good. I knew that I would. I feel good. I knew that I would. So good, so good, I got you, woo! people watching us right now.
I don't know, man. I'm glad to go get some breakfast.
Holla. Enjoy your breakfast, man. Thanks for thinking of me. Okay, ask me anything. Is there something I could do right now other than hitting the finish button that would make your day? Be reasonable. That's my wife right there. Right there. That's my wife. And she might be watching. So behave. Wait a minute. I'm sorry. I'm talking to myself. Have a great day, folks, members of Choice. Wherever you go, whatever you do, do it in a Subaru. And we'll talk to you tomorrow morning. Catch the rewind tonight at 8 o'clock. And I have this to say. You ready? Later.